Thank you everyone for your time, and it's a pleasure to introduce our work here. So our paper is about to measure the signature entrenchment and introducing the conceptual changes in automated theory repair. Due to the limited time, I think I will just focus on signature entrenchment in this talk. In artificial agents, concepts are written with a signature containing predicates and their arguments. So for example, in data one, we have predicate mom, which have three arguments. And so we can interpret it like Lily is Victor's birth mom. And then in another data, you have mom, but it doesn't have the type. So you can see the concepts represented in different data are quite different, that you have no idea about the type in the second one. And then the motherhood concept can be also represented in another way. For example, like in this data three, you have the type attached to the predicate symbol. Then it is comparing with the data one, it is more accurate by the predicate symbol. So if you have a process which give you change one data version from any of this to the other, then that is a conceptual change. For more details, please see our paper, and we have a formal definition there. And then we believe that signature entrenchment, which measures the informational value of a signature element like a predicate or an argument, can help us to rank conceptual changes. So the framework of our work is that we have two inputs. One is a benchmark, including positive examples and negative examples. And then we have a data log theory, a data log data here. Then we can check whether there is any inconsistency between the data and the benchmark. If there is, then we can buy another repairing system, which is named ABC, but we don't introduce it here. It can be the faulty data can be automatically repaired, but usually you will get a lot of candidates of fault-free data. And what we want is that we can rank those repaired data based on the entrenchment. So the assumption here is that all the information given by the benchmark is fully trusted, including the way all the concepts written there. So we'll start with argument entrenchment. It is a measure for the how important an argument is for a predicate. So we believe it is based on how diversity an argument can be. For example, in the mom assertion, there in your data you could have lots of different individuals as mom, and you have lots of individuals as children, but there will be limited types of mom. In this case, I think it's quite consistent with human judgment. We will give a score based on how large the set of each argument can be. And then that is the argument entrenchment score. In this case, the third argument is the least entrenched one. So if you think about, I think this is exactly, well, at least for some of the human judgment that we collected, it is correct. If you imagine that you lost the first argument and you know that Victor has a birth mom, but there is no any other information you can get from this assertion. If you lost the second argument, then you know Lily have given birth to someone, but you don't know who this person is. However, if you lost the third one, you will know that at least Lily is Victor's mom, but maybe she can be the birth mom or stepmom or godmom, but there are limited choices. So that thinking about how to recover, even if you have a whole database and by some mistake, you don't know some part of the arguments, then the possibility of correctly recovering those assertions are relevant to the size of each argument size. And then Yeah, that's how we measure the argument entrenchment based on the size of size. The next main contribution is about the measuring practical entrenchment. So recall the benchmark we mentioned, it has positive examples and negative examples. All the predicates occur in the benchmark is highlighted in red here. This is a, we use a theory graph to provide the base of the measurement. Here, all the nodes represent the predicates we have in the data. And then the red ones has occurred in the benchmark. So we fully trusted them. And then for the rest ones, they occur only in the data, the input data. And the relation between different predicates are decided by the rules they are involved in. For example, bird can imply fly. Then this arrow from bird to fly to indicate the implication relation. And which means that we can draw this theory graph for data uniquely. And then based on this graph, we can calculate how far a predicate is from the benchmark following those arrows. So that we can see in this example, bird and wings are the only ones which is now involved in the benchmark. And then wings is quite far from the benchmark because it is not a precondition of any other predicate that in the benchmark. So in this case, the further predicate is to the benchmark, the less trusted it is. So the less entrenched it is. In this case, the formula the measurement is given in the paper, but we don't write it here. All the blue numbers here give you the corresponding predicate entrenchment scores and followed by the distance scores. So that we can see bird is more entrenched than wings and less entrenched than the other ones in the benchmark. Here we imagine that it's following our common sense. The benchmark gives you the fact that penguin tweeter cannot fly, so that this original data is faulty, and then it can be repaired in different ways. Here, the left one is a desired one because it can split bird into flying one and implicitly non-flying one. So that the seagull can be given as a flying bird, while the penguin is not. The red one is not a good repair because it says that, you know, penguin can fly abnormal, or it splits fly into a fly abnormal and fly, which is normally. But according to common sense, that is not really what we want to see. We don't say penguin can abnormally fly. It just cannot fly. In this case, absolutely, the left one is a better repair. And then if we think about how we rank these two repairs based on the entrenchment, we can see the left one is ranking higher because bird is the less entrenched predicate and fly is a more entrenched one. So that the left one is ranked on the top, which is the desired result. So our conclusion is that we gave scores to measure the entrenchment for predicates and arguments. And the application is to ranking the repairs based on the smallest reductions or the biggest overall entrenchment scores. Well, the limitation, there are still many limitations. One is that we cannot compare across predicates and arguments. Another one is that we still need more experiments to compare our automated score, calculated scores with human judgment. So yeah, we will do more future work with regard to engagement measurements. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Shrey. If anybody has any questions, I don't see any questions in the Slack channel yet. Just a reminder, yes, Ricky, I see you have a question.
Yes, thank you for your talk. I'm interested in your work. I have a question is, what do you think your work has the potential to extend to other formalisms? Because I noticed that your input data log theory, can it be extended to like description logic or first order logic? Do you think about this?
Yes, I think that, thank you for your question, first of all. And the answer would be yes, because if you think of, well, for the predicate entrenchment, it can be definitely extended easily to other formats because the only thing it needed is the benchmark. And as long as you have benchmark and you have the input data you want to check, then you can calculate the score. However, for the argument entrenchment, it's a little bit tricky because if you want to know the size of an argument, then it means that you want to know the whole set of theorems, which can be impossible in some time, in some cases, for example, first order logic. But if in many real cases, for example, knowledge graphs, they explicitly give you all the information they can have, they can offer. So you can, maybe in that case, you can calculate the scores for argument entrenchment just based on the information you already have.